Welcome to the second show of the Breezeway tonight, everybody. This has been a fantastic start to a great night. This is episode 2 of season 7, second show, and we've got Angie Austin back. Angie's a longtime Breezeway supporter, been on all 7 years, but we're going to get some questions flying in a bit there.
Yeah, we will. Just again, to start out the show, thanks a lot for joining us, folks at home, and we know there's no studio audience, but your loyalty shows and tuning in and supporting live music from home.
Yes, fantastic, and hit the share button and the like button, everybody. This has been a great to get back streaming live music again over our little lull.
Sure has, and we want to again thank Donna and Reg Alder for letting us come in into their garage, award-winning garage, for On Location, Breezeway award-winning place, and we sure make ourselves at home here because it's so comfy.
It is so. Even up at Centennial Lake there, we've been known to follow Donna and Reg up to their cottage up there too.
And the stars must have aligned tonight, Franny, because Fred brought cookies.
I know.
I didn't think he was cooking anymore.
I know, he's kept it pretty quiet over there, a couple doors down, but he's back in action.
Well, that's a good thing
and
for us.
There's something lemon coming next week.
Oh, boy.
I've got the insider on it. For everybody at home who don't know, I'm Franny, and this is Greg, my co-host here tonight, and I'd like to do a shout out to our team behind the cameras, behind the scenes, doing a hard job, all of us.
Yeah, Mike Stapleton behind camera one. Orpha on, or sorry, Orpha's correcting me, and Orpha's the boss. Yeah. Right? So Mike's on camera two, Orpha's on camera one. And of course, producer Brenda back there, and Dennis on sound.
Now, just quickly, Greg, I see you got a CD from the last show. If you'd like to just do a little shout-out there. And
I've been waiting for this for so long. And, I mean, I used to have the actual cassette of all of Slim's songs. But I see on here we have some Slim, Ontario Slim and Friends. So I'm looking forward to popping that into the CD player.
Fantastic.
And they still exist in some cars.
Really?
Yeah, some cars, folks.
We're yeah, not too many on the road, maybe, but
no, it's terrible. Anyway, sponsors, Mill Pond Music and Entertainment. Shane and I are so happy to be a part of the Breezeway each and every week, and what it does for musicians and people alike around the world. Music does heal people, and we're proving it right
through
this pandemic.
Yes, and thank you very much. Cathroy Stables and our Brooking Tree Services in Port Hope. We certainly do miss the Golden Girls, but thanks for your ongoing support throughout the
years. Port Hope Denture Center come on board during the pandemic and have supported us throughout and remained a great loyal sponsor to the Breezeway.
Share Tune Sounds as well, everybody, and Johnson Septic. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you, everybody, and all your donations that continue to come on in every week. We appreciate it. You know, whatever that amount is, it helps with costs and things so that we can continue to improve here at the Breezeway and continue to bring you live music every week.
All right, I'm looking forward to this first round of music here because I've got some questions for this guest right here.
You didn't prepare me.
I did. You don't need prepared because you're the only one that knows the answers.
Okay.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get our second show started here tonight. Put your hands together and welcome Miss Angie Austin, everybody.
Thank you. All right. We're going to start her off with a good old Driving Nails in the Coffin. My sweetheart is sad and so lonely. She said he and I were through. I've started out drinking for pastime. Driving nails in my coffin over you. Well, I'm just driving nails in my coffin. Every time I drink a bottle of booze, I'm just driving nails in my coffin. I'm driving those nails over you. Ever since the day that we parted, you said you were bad and so blue. Thinking that old booze. I'm just driving nails in my car every time I drink a bottle of booze. I'm just driving nails in my coffin. I'm driving those nails over you. You turn me down, you don't want me. There's nothing now I can lose. I'm just driving those nails in my coffin. And I'm driving
you. I'd like to thank Dave Chown for offering to come out and help me. There's nothing better than having a bass player with you. So thank you, Dave, for coming out. I appreciate it. And I sent him my set list with all the notes, their keys, and then I just told him tonight, I said, well, don't do it in that key. We're going to change it. So we're doing this one in the key of B. This is one of my favorite George Strait tunes.
Well, I knew the stakes were high right from the start. When she dealt the cards, I dealt my heart. Now I just found a game that this is where the cowboy rides away, and my heart is sinking like the setting sun. Setting on the things I'd wish I'd done. Well, it's time to say this is where the cowboy rides away. We've been in and out of love and in between. Now we play the final showdown scene. As the credits roll, that song starts to play. This is where the cowboy rides away, and my heart is sinking like a setting sun. Setting on the things I'd wish I. This is where the cowboy rides away. Oh, the last goodbyes the heart is one to say. This is where the cowboy rides away. Yeah, this is.
Thank you. you. You're not throwing questions at me yet, eh? All right, so this one I just actually learned a couple of days ago. And I threw it at Dave. I said, here, gotta learn this one. How'd you make out? Yeah, we'll see. This is called She's a Miracle, but I changed the words to He's a Miracle because I'm pretty blessed. Been married for almost 25 years to my husband, Chris, and I find that he's my miracle, so I'm very grateful for him.
Well, I don't need no shooting star to make my wish come true. And I don't need a four-leaf clover, a crystal ball to see through. For fame, like some folks always do. I got my very own big time star, and he shines the whole night through. He's a miracle, a sight to see. Oh, the way he touches me, way down deep in my soul. Something's got a hold and it won't let go. If I stumble and if I fall, he's waiting there to catch me. Oh, he's a miracle, miracle to me. I don't need any good luck charms always hanging around. Don't need any wishing well, put my money down. And I don't need to make the front page news or be the talk of the town. I'm telling all the world I got a heavenly man right here on the ground. Well, he's a miracle, a sight to see. Oh, the way he touches me, way down deep in my soul. Something's got a hold and it won't let go. If I stumble and if I fall, he's waiting there to catch me. Oh, he's a miracle, miracle to me. He's everything in the world to me, a beautiful dream come true. Every day I count my blessings, 'cause I'm the lucky one he gave his loving to. Oh, he's a miracle, a sight to see. Oh, the way he touches me, way down deep, well in my soul. Something's got a hold and it won't let go. If I stumble and if I fall, waiting there to catch me. Oh, he's a miracle, miracle to me.
Thank you. I love that tune. All right. So, any truckers out there?
I'll say yeah.
I'll say yeah. All right, we got a trucker out there. What's that? So this is a cool little ditty. It's a Kathy Mattea tune, and yeah, you know that song already. So this is going out to all those men on the road. It's called 18 Wheels.
Charlie's got a gold watch, don't seem like a whole lot. After 30 years of driving up and down the interstate. But Charlie's got a good life, and Charlie's got a good wife. And after tonight, she'll no longer be counting the days. 18 wheels and a dozen roads. one that he loves. They'll buy a Winnebago, set out to find America, do a lot of catching up, a little at a time. With pieces of the old dream, they're gonna light the old flame, doing what they please, leaving every other reason behind. If you know the words, sing it. 18 wheels and a dozen roses,
1 that he loves. Fantastic.
Angie Austin, everybody.
You know, that's all fresh music.
Yes, very it nice.
Is. That very nice. Is. I noticed that right off, Angie. That's fantastic.
Yeah, now she did mention that she has Dave Chown backing her up, but he's one of the finest backup dancers I've ever seen, and she hasn't even taken advantage of that yet.
Well, you did get a smile from Dave there because he knows what we're talking about.
Well, Father Chown can cut a rug, I'll tell you.
Okay, Angie, I've been waiting to ask the question. If you were to explain, it's kind of a different question, but if you were to explain the Breezeway to somebody that never heard of the Breezeway before, thus the public that's tuned in, how would you go about explaining the Breezeway knowing that you've been 7 seasons on the show? I know it's on the spot.
You put me on the spot.
I did, yes.
And a lot of changes.
Yes, there has been a lot of changes. So when people do ask me, what is the Breezeway? I always tell them, well, it's an online music, and they're featuring local great musicians and singers, and they're just an incredible bunch of people, and I am so grateful to know them. And if you want to check out some great music, some local music, the Breezeway, tune in to the Breezeway, because that's the place to be. And I've been with you guys since day one when you and BB was doing it, and I'm very happy to continue to be. And so thank you so much, guys, for keep asking me. I love being part of it.
Yeah. Thank you so much, and you have seen the highlights and the lowlights from the Breezeway over the 7 years.
Yep.
It's been fantastic, and I'd like to think that it's a Breezeway family just with the musicians in itself, because I know a lot of musicians have hooked up and played just from the Breezeway and met down the road at jamborees and stuff,
absolutely.
And make those connections, and that's huge in the music that we do and bring to you at home too. So
yes,
thank you so much.
I am so grateful for our family of musicians and stuff. Without them, I'd just be a lost little soul.
Hundreds, Angie. There's hundreds.
We've
had thousands of artists on the stage.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to believe just how many musicians are local and from around the world that come far and wide to play on the Breezeway.
And the music has changed me as a person. Just I'm a much happier person. Music and being around you guys and all you guys has just been an awesome adventure.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
It is fantastic. And like Angie said, we go from closet player musicians that have never played in front of a crowd to musicians that have played in packed stadiums. It's really across the board, and it's a chance for everybody to share their musical talents.
And through my eyesight, too, is like, yes, we've had some really, really good guests on, but the find down at Happy Green Acres, when Shane heard that young lady in the crowd sing.
She was amazing.
Isn't that, that's really what it's about. I know that the rest of us have a platform, but to find those gems, it was fantastic, and I just like to say that for me, it was fantastic fun.
Sure is, and thanks to people and musicians like yourself, Angie, for telling people about us, for one, but also, supporting the musicians that we have on the show through watching their shows or commenting or just some encouragement. It goes a long way.
And love the fresh material, too. That's awesome. You've got to add a couple of dandies. That's fantastic.
It's nerve-wracking, but I thought, you know what? I got to throw in some. We've had COVID, so I've had lots of time to practice new tunes. So.
Well, yeah, that's awesome.
I got more to come.
Fantastic choices.
One last thing, Angie. Tell everybody where you're from. I know you're proud of your hometown or where you're living.
I am very proud, yep.
And how to get a hold of you, maybe.
Sure. Well, I'm from the big town of Kendall. Mike Stapleton knows where I'm from. And I'm very proud to be there. And if you can want to find me again, you can find me on Facebook, definitely, and message me. Yep. I'm all
fantastic.
Over Facebook.
Awesome.
Good stuff. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's get back to some music. We'll do some more talking afterwards. Angie Austin,
all
everybody.
Right.
Around you when the lonely nights surround you, how I love to be alone with you. What I'd give to have the power to read your mind 1 hour, how I love to be alone with you. Just to be with you a night, you and me alone, kiss your lips and hold you tight and have you for my own. This would be joy unending, could be a real beginning, how I love to be alone with you.
Do a solo there, Dave. Mr. Dave Chown on bass. Another one that I said would be in the key of A, but I lied. Oh my goodness, I have. There we go. I'm going to turn that down a little bit, Dennis. Okay. Is there a hum? So this is a Vern Goslin tune. It's called Way Down Deep in My Soul.
This highway of heartache is rocky and rough, Lord, I learned a long time ago. You can't build a fire from the ashes of love, the roses don't bloom in the snow. Down deep inside my soul, where once it was cold and dark, take a hold way down deep in my heart. You were my light on the darkest of days, those storms that were raging within. And slowly but surely the clouds rolled away and the sun started shining again. Down deep inside my soul, where once it was cold and dark, I feel your love take a hold way
vodka.
Bread.
Deep. It doesn't work. It won't stay.
I think that's a blonde moment, right, Julie? Okay, so this one is called Memory Number One.
Well, I've got lots of golden memories of a million things that I have said and done.
Harmony. Well, I can hear the harmony and it sounds really, really good. All right. So this one is another one that I've recently just learned. And I'm one of those people that when I learn a song, that or when I hear a song, and if I'm connect to it, I like to learn it. And this one I definitely connected to. It's called my what? Yep, I can check my connections. Yep. So this is called You Gotta Keep Your Heart Young, and it's a really cool little ditty. 3, 4. I think it's the key. And I'm dedicating it to all of you guys, and really listen to the words. It's a really cool song. I love it.
My grandpa gave me a wheat penny, and I kept it in my pocket. And I had big plans in my backyard to build me a space rocket. I talked to my brother on a fake CD that I made from a Tic Tac box. I packed my snowballs nice and tight, and in the middle I put rocks. Well, don't trade in your Tic Tac box for a ball on the end of a chain. Don't go spending grandpa's pennies buying into the game. You gotta keep hill. Speed got the best of me, and I took my first spill. Well, that was back when alcohol was only used on cuts. It stung like hell, so it jerked my leg. My mama said it would give me guts. Well, don't trade in your tic-tac box for a ball on the end of a chain. Spending grandpa's pennies, buying into the game. You gotta keep your heart young, but don't go growing old when all your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. You gotta keep your heart young. So take a picture of the one and put it in a locket. Go dig up your time capsule and the blueprints for your rocket. We'll keep in touch on the fake CP with that same old tic-tac box. Pack your snowballs a little less tight, but in the middle, still put rocks. Don't trade in your tic-tac box for a ball on the end of a chain. Don't go spending grandpa's pennies, buying into the game. You gotta keep your heart young. Don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. You gotta keep your heart young. Yeah, you gotta keep your heart young.
Yeah.
Fantastic job, Angie.
Way to go, Angie. Great new music.
Now, the decorations. Is there a story behind your decorations up there with your sunflowers there?
Have you? Well, maybe.
That's the first I seen of the
My son, I love sunflowers. I'm a big fan of sunflowers. But I did a show at the, we had a sunflower fest for the Kendall Lions Club just recently. And I did a show and I bought some sunflowers because I don't like the look of my iPad. So I bought the sunflowers to kind of cover my iPad. And I thought I would just make it a little cute.
Nice.
That's fantastic. I was just talking to Donna, that we're at Donna's place here filming tonight, and she was surprised at the musicians coming from far and wide, like Dave coming down to play with you, and Dean Austin and stuff. And I said, you know, musicians to help musicians out for that sound and stuff, you can always count. And it's fantastic to see that stuff going on still. So.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's great.
And just to set Dave Chown sitting in on bass tonight and backup dancing, just want to let him know that Thousand Island Casino called and his seat's still warm. So when he gets back to that.
Do you remember the dance school that Dave went to? I know that he got a certificate. Did you? Dave, what was the name of the place? Arthur Murray's School of Dance, actually. Yeah. And there's a certificate out there floating around with Dave's name on it.
Yeah.
Fantastic, Dave.
And, you know, Angie's been doing this a long time, folks, and I always try to throw in a question that will give a little back to a younger person. And Mike actually brought this up when we were outside. But, Angie, back in the day, and I don't remember this because every time you've been on our stages, you're cool as a cucumber. But back in the day, apparently you used to get quite nervous for a show. So what helps you to get ready for a show?
I still get nervous for a show. Oh, my goodness. I'll never forget. So what I do is I will take a long walk, and I'm heavy breathing, like heavy breathing, and I have to be alone. I have to be alone. I have to focus and just get my bearings together before I get on the show. But I find that even though I'm nervous before my show starts, as soon as I get on that stage and the band starts to play, it's like the nerves just go away.
It's go time.
I'm ready to hit that stage.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people that I have asked that question to, Angie, have said that if they're not nervous, they know something's wrong.
Yeah.
Like they, it's just a nerve thing that happens to a lot of musicians, yeah. and people find different ways to calm that down.
Can you give Orpha the thumbs up there for a photo there?
Yes.
Look at there, she said. I love those photos. Now, Angie, we had the pleasure of having your daughter on when she first started singing. Mm-hmm. Is she still singing?
Not as much, no. She works more than me.
She's too busy.
She's too busy. She's a very busy girl. I have tried to get her back into singing, but she's just, no, I've got to go to work or I got to go do this, and yeah.
Now, before we get back to the tunes, do you want to tell everybody your profession out there? Your frontline
sure.
frontline worker,
yeah.
And been strong the whole time this COVID, and we've got to thank you for that as well,
thank
for
you.
What you do.
Yeah, yeah, thank you, Angie.
Yeah, thank so. You. Well, I'm a nurse, and I work at a doctor's office, a very, very busy office in Brooklyn, and I have worked for seniors for almost 25 years, but I finally retired from doing that, and I am so happy where I am now, and I get weekends off, and I can do music, and I don't get calls in the middle of the night.
Fantastic.
Excellent.
And you deserve
excellent.
It, and thanks for all your hard work.
Well,
that's
thank
fantastic.
You. Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we got lots of music left. Share us around with all your country music love and friends.
Share.
All over the world, we're seen anywhere between 80 and 100,000 times a month, and that's for good reason. It's good music, and it will heal you.
Put your virtual hands together for Angie Austin.
Yay. Just follow the stairway to this lonely world of mine. You'll find me waiting here in apartment. So very long ago, you walked away from me. And after all the plans we made, you decided to be free. Loneliness surrounds me. Thank you. You know, I came in here and heard Julie sing, and I thought, holy lifting, how am I going to follow that power voice? She's just incredible. Julie, you did a fantastic show tonight. Just fantastic. And I'm so glad to call you my friend. We had a good time dancing, me and Julie and Kathy and all kinds of friends dancing. So I gotta learn how to dance with you, I hear. So as I said, I like to connect to my songs, and I connect to this one very much, Lee. It's called High Cotton. I've been raised on a farm all my life.
We didn't know the times were late. Round our house the grass was green. Didn't seem like we were all that bad. I bet we walked 1,000 miles, chopping cotton and pushing plows, and learning how to give it all we had. As life went on and years went by, I saw the light in my daddy's eyes and felt the love in my mama's hands. Well, they kept us warm and they kept us fed. They taught us how to look ahead. And looking back, well, now I understand. We were walking in high cotton. Oh, times there are not forgotten. Those fertile fields are never far away. Walking in high cotton, what times there are not forgotten. Leaving home was the hardest thing I ever faced.
This is a true story.
When Sunday mornings rolled around, we dressed up in hand-me-downs, just in time to gather with the church. Sometimes I think how long it's been, and how it impressed me then. It was the only day my daddy didn't work. We were walking in high cotton. Oh, times there are not forgotten. Those fertile fields are never far away. We were walking in high cotton. Oh, times there are not forgotten. Leaving home was the hardest thing we ever faced. One more time. We were walking in high cotton. Oh, times there are not. Those fertile fields are never far away. We were walking in high cotton. Oh, times there are not forgotten. Leaving home was the hardest thing we ever faced. We were walking in high cotton.
Thank you. All right, this one. This one's a little gospel song, and I'm dedicating it to my friends, Gord and Tish Whaley. Gord asked me to do this song. So, sadly, a few years ago, Gord and Tish had lost their son unexpectedly, and they had a rose bush outside, and it's named after their son, and every year, he's so proud of his rose bush. And I found this song, and I played it for him one night, and he just fell in love with it, and it's called The Roses Bloom Again. So this is for you, Gordon Tish.
I planted a little rose bush, tended it with care. As buds began to blossom, your sweet fragrance filled. Sweetheart, loving wife for 40 years.
That's a tough song to sing, I tell you. Especially when I put that dedication out. It got me a little emotional there. So here's another new one that I... Wait. Am I seeing things? I need my glasses. You don't look like Greg. I think... don't put me on the spot there, Fred. So this is another new one that I just learned. It's called Who's She to You?
I've been watching you, and you've been watching her. You look like you just saw a ghost. Someone else before I came along. I've often wondered who she was and was she really gone? Who's she to you and where does that leave me? Is she still in your heart or just a memory? Tell me goodbye. Who's she to you? And darling, who am I? The looks you're giving her are doing things to me. You say there is no reason at all for my jealousy. As long as there's little smoke, fire's never cold. If history repeats itself, what does our future hold? Well, who's she to you? And where does that leave me? Is she still in your heart? Or just a
awesome.
I'm G. Austin.
Check, 1, 2.
Yep. We lost 3, the 4. Sound in the boys.
We did lose the mic. What? Check, 1, 2.
Hello?
Oh, Fred's working.
You got me.
Hi, Fred.
I'm always working. How you doing, Andrew?
I'm good.
You do such a great job up there. You blow me away every time. Aww. How do you pick the songs that you play?
How do I pick the songs? Well, like I said, I do like to connect to my songs. So sometimes people just send me a song and they say, you should learn this one. And if I like it, if I don't like it, then I'll learn it. If I like it, if I don't like it, then I just leave it alone. But I'm just usually just trying to find songs that I can connect to. The more I connect to it, the better.
Well, you never fail as far as I'm concerned.
Aw. Thank you.
I love you too.
Fredward is in the house. Fred, when you started into the Breezeway here, I just got a brief story. Angie and her husband built, Chris built a nice bar, and we had Fred's bar. And then after that, we had advice from Fred. And then after that, we had cooking with Fred, right? And we thought you'd give up on the cooking, but you redeemed yourself tonight with the cookies, because the next episode that we were going to get Fred to do was sex talk with Fred. And you redeemed yourself with cookies tonight, and I'm very proud of you, and they're damn good cookies.
I still would like to see the sex talk with Fred.
And you ain't gonna get no sex talk out of me, buddy. That just won't happen.
Oh dear.
Oh, boy. Are we ever glad to be back, Fred, to see the live music and stuff? And everybody knows that you've got a new look going on without the glasses. So if you want to tell everybody how you made out through the transition.
Well, I went to get my eyes tested. They told me I had cataracts. Had to have them removed. And since I got them removed, free of glasses. I love it.
Fantastic. And you just took 10 years off of doing that, Fred. And we got 10 more years of giving her as the Breezeway, too. We're going to hand it back over, everybody. Yeah, you got new chompers.
I just want to give thanks to Port Hope Denture Clinic for my new teeth.
Yay!
Thanks, Bob.
Okay. Whole new man.
Show them the pearly whites. Give them a big smile out there, Facebook land. Look at her. You've got her made, brother. You've got her made. We do have a lot of fun, buddy.
We do so.
All right, everybody, we're going to pass it back over to the stage here. Put your virtual hands together, everybody, for Angie Austin.
You know, it's funny, Franny, that you were talking about sex talk with Fred, because I'm thinking, well, that just kind of leads perfectly right into this song that I'm about to do. So it's another brand new tune that I learned, and again, Fred, I connected very close to this song. And actually, I'm going to dedicate this song out to Brenda. And because I'm sure we have a fishing man over here, right? Or a hunting man. And sometimes he takes off and he doesn't do his honey to list, right? Yeah. So this song is called Headache, and I hope you enjoy it. All week long now you've been promising me you spend today at home. I've got your honey-do list all made up, ready to go. Now you're loading up your fishing gear, say your buddy's on his way. Before you pull out the drive, honey, all I'm gonna say, well, I feel a headache coming on. I think this one's a doozy, it might last all so go on, that's fine, have a good time, but remember while you're gone, well, I feel a headache coming on. Now don't forget you've got a birthday coming up real soon, and I bought something special I was gonna wear for you. Cause I feel a headache coming on. I think this one's a doozy, it might last all month long. So go on, that's fine, have a good time, but remember while you're gone, well, I feel a headache coming on. Now if your dad said I'm going, I don't wanna change your plans, but you know I can hold out a lot longer than you can. Well, I feel a headache coming on, and I think this one's a migraine, it might last all year long. So go on. Your sake, well, I've got a headache coming on. Well, I thought you'd see that my way. Oh, yeah, I love that tune so much. Yep. Two more. All right. I can do two. That's perfect. All right. So this one is another newbie that I learned, and it's called You Don't Know Who I Am, and I'm changing it to the key of B. Yep. So this is kind of a song. It's a very dark song. And it's kind of about, you know, a man and a woman, and they're both dealing with leaving one another.
She left the car in the driveway. She left the key in the door. She left the kids at her mama's. The laundry piled up on the floor. She left her ring on her pillow, right where it wouldn't be missed. She left her note in the kitchen, right next to that grocery list. It said, you don't even know who I am. Let me
the ring on her pillow. He left the clothes on the floor,
and he called her to say he was sorry, but he couldn't remember what for. Thinking that maybe you're right. I go to work every morning, and I come home to you every night.
All right, so we got one more song, Dave, and I think we'll do the one that you and I like to do together. Once more? You got no mic? Oh, we can fix that. You do now.
Say what?
Check one.
There we go. All right, well, thank you, Franny and Greg and Fred and all you guys, Brenda, Orpha, Mike, Dennis, great job on the sounder, loving it. And thank you so much, guys, for having me. And Dave, thank you again for coming out and playing with me. playing music with me. Better get that right. So this one, my last song, is called Once More.
Once more.
Singing the chorus with me. Come on, girls. Come on. I can hear you back there doing the harmonies. Birthday girl.
Fantastic job, guys. That's awesome. Big virtual hand to Angie Austin. That was awesome.
Yeah. Way to go, Angie. And,
thank you.
And joined by our first guest of the night, Julie Simpson. And, you know, it's awesome what happens on the Breezeway stage.
It definitely is. It definitely is. Angie, hats off to all your, because I follow you and know your music and stuff. And that was fresh and awesome.
Thank you.
So, folks, tonight we featured two of the, what I believe are the premier female vocalists around in the area. And I think they deserve to be on plenty of stages. So if you're looking for female artists, look no further than we saw tonight.
Okay, Greg, why don't you tell everybody what's going on next week and our guests?
Next week, folks, we can't say for sure, but we're hoping to have a studio audience. We're just waiting on details.
It's coming.
But regardless, we're going to have, in show number one, we're going to have multi-award-winning duo Austin Young. And then for the first time ever on the Breezeway live Tuesday night, Ramblin' Fever is going to follow them.
Fantastic. So if you don't get a chance to follow Ramblin' Fever, that's one band that you really should. They're exciting, high energy, country, fun-loving guys, and they might even have a special guest.
They just might. You never know.
If the moon and the sun and everything's aligned, we'll see a real smoking show out of the...
So, and we have to apologize, folks. I did get a chance to talk to Father Dave Chown, and he would have liked to have danced tonight, but there's just not enough room here to warm up. So maybe next week, we'll see what we can do.
And when we feature Dave, I just want a big shout out to Arthur Murray School of Dance.
Yes.
If you're looking, look that up online. And
I can't imagine how much work they went through.
Listen, they're a good dance club. I've seen the work from Dave. Yeah. They're a great dance club to be involved with. So
I think Elvis went there too, maybe. Just from okay. The pelvic action.
All right, we're landing on a little thick. Once again, thanks to our sponsors. We can't do it without you. Thanks for the people who donate online also. Hope to have a hall and a crowd next week with the guests that we got coming in. We're super excited.
And don't forget, if you're looking to book for the Breezeway second stage for next summer, the festival season, get in touch with us as soon as you can. Dates are booking up quick, and we're really happy about that and really excited about that. And also, if you're looking for a date on the Breezeway Live on Tuesday nights, make sure you get us a message or send us an email to inthebreezeway@gmail.com. We'll see if we can get you on the show.
All right, that's exciting, man. I'd like to see some, we've met so many new people through the lockdown, the Breezeway lockdown page. It'd be nice to have some new people come through the Breezeway as
sure
well.
Will.
We gotta keep the old ones on, Angie. That's what it's built on, and it's been fantastic.
Yes, and we keep that rolling. I mean, there's some people that won't get on the show this year, but we'll fit as many as we can, as we always do.
All right, until next week, and the lemon tarts come in from Fred.
Yes.
Yes. Tell them it's either lemon
tarts or sex talk.
We're getting lemon tarts
lemon
by the looks of
it.
Tell them who we are, buddy.
We're the Breezeway guys.
See you next week, folks.